Hey guys! So today's video is going to be all about drugstore, nude or pale lipsticks. If you've been watching my videos for a while, you probably noticed that I tend to stick to nude lipsticks just because I find that they really bring out your eyes and I always tend to draw attention to my eyes rather than my lips just because I prefer my eyes to my lips. Alright, so first I'm going to start out with my absolute favourites. So my pretty much favourite go-to lipstick by far is NYX's Black Label lipstick. So it looks like this in nude, which is a nice way to start off the video. A lipstick called Nude. So first things first, it smells delicious. It smells like grapes. Yeah. So I got this off some online website. I don't know what site it was because I buy it from all different websites, but it looks like this. I still haven't worn it yet because I haven't worn this one yet because I bought two backups because I love it that much. So yeah. Now because I want to give you a really good indication of what the colours actually look like, I'm not going to just swatch them on my hand because my hand is a whole different colour to my lips. So I'm going to put them all on my lips so you can see what they're going to look like. And this is the colour of my lips naturally. They're kind of dark pinkish, pinkish purplish, I guess. So that is NYX's Black Label lipstick in nude. Yeah, I literally cannot even explain to you how much I love this lipstick. It's so creamy and moisturizing and it never, ever, ever feels dry on your lips. It's a really opaque, strong color. It is not sheer. It fully covers up the color of your lips and it's so cheap. I don't know how much it was, really like $5 maybe. Yeah, I bought it online for those of you who also live in Australia. Yeah, and you can always get them on sale on some website. But that's the first one. I just wanted to start out with a product that I loved and I had to have a little rave about it just because it's so great. So the next product is only available in Australia. It is one that I have only recently come across and the only bad thing I can say about it is that it smells like grandma's. You know how some lipsticks smell like perfume and that perfume kind of reminds you of a smell that your grandma would wear? Yeah, this is what it smells like and that really irritates me, but oh well. So it is by Face of Australia. So it's called the Lip Quench SPF 30+. Well, there you go, that's another good thing about it. It has SPF 30+ in it with shea butter and jojoba oil or jojoba or jojoba. I don't know how to pronounce that. But anyway, and it is in the colour Iced Almond. Okay, so this little baby looks like this. It is a very, very nude colour. I'm not really sure why they call it Iced Almond, but whatever. So yeah, very, very nude colour. But it just smells like grandma's. So that is that one. Now, I'm really fussy with my nude lipsticks because they can't be too blue-toned or cold-toned or cool-toned. I just never wear lipsticks that have that kind of tinge to them because they just do not suit me at all. Or they cannot have too much brown in them. Ah, someone's ringing me. My dad. Hold up. Hi, Dad. Sorry about that. That was just my dad calling. Okay, it doesn't dry your lips out. It isn't as moisturizing as this one, and it's not as pinky as this one, but it still is probably more of a nude, like a strict nude, as you can tell. Doesn't leave you looking dead or anything like that. So I would really recommend this one. It was about $9 or $10, so it's really, really affordable. So the next lipstick I will review is my old holy grail favourite lipstick ever. I used to use it every single weekend when I used to go out clubbing, which was like every single weekend, sometimes twice a week, until I found that NYX one. So it is, I keep on taking off the packaging before I show you. It is Inoxa's lipstick, which I just realised and remembered is only available in Australia as far as I know. So Inoxa lipstick in Peaches and Cream. I can't even bother trying to wait for this to focus. There you go. And the only problem with this one is that it is very, very matte. So you usually need like a gloss or something before you apply it, but oh well. So this is what the Inoxa lipstick in Peaches and Cream looks like. So it is a very, very light kind of colour, more pale than it is nude. And it is kind of pinkish or salmon-y pinkish toned. I absolutely love it still, but I just kind of irritates me that it's matte because I have a lot of little lines in my lips, so it tends to kind of crack in those lines and kind of settle into them, and it looks really weird when I smile or anything like that. But when it's first applied, it's lovely. I just wish it was in more of a glossy kind of, had more of a glossy formula, but it's still awesome and really, really nice with the gloss over the top, and it has no distinct bad smell or anything like that either, so that's really good. So the next lipstick is probably the most known drugstore nude lipstick, excuse me, by Revlon, and it has the awesome quilted packaging. Yep, and then the colour is 070 Soft Nude, and it is the Revlon Colourburst lipstick. Now my mum's calling me. Hello! So this one I kind of have like a love-hate relationship with, just because I find that once I apply it, the colour changes after a while. It becomes darker and more brown, and I definitely don't like wearing brown-coloured nude colours. Nude lipsticks, that's the one. But it's still kind of a nice colour, and I did wear it for a while, but then I kind of found better ones, so I kind of just got over it. It doesn't have much of a smell. The smell isn't nice, but it's not terrible either. It kind of smells a little bit plasticky, or like plasticine or something like that. But anyway, I'll apply a little bit of this for you. So that, oh, my nose is so itchy. Okay. So that is the Revlon lipstick in Soft Nude. It is quite a nice colour once you first apply it, I will admit. I quite like that colour. It's pretty moisturising and nice, but then after a while the colour becomes darker, more brown, and it dries out and it kind of sinks into the cracks in your lips, which I don't really appreciate, but yeah. I know some people do love this one, and I guess it just depends on your own personal experiences with it, but myself, I wouldn't really count on it as like a go-to nude lipstick, but it still is decent. The next one is from Rimmel. It is their Moisture Renew lipstick in 700 Nude Delight. It has this bright purple packaging. It looks kind of blue on camera, but it's purple. And then that is the colour. Now this one I don't really like that much, and I don't think I've ever actually worn it. The next lipstick is the NYX Round Lipstick, I think that's what they're called, in Orange Soda. So this one is good in terms of the colour payoff. It is quite opaque. It's very creamy, almost more glossy than creamy, and could also be a little bit too glossy for my liking, but that's just personal preference really. And it is very, very orange based, obviously because it's called Orange Soda, but it is more on the orange side than the pink side, if that makes sense. So if you're not into pinks or cool toned lipsticks, then I suggest this one. So I'll just put this on. So as you can see, it's very, very, it's almost like a light fluoro pastel orange, if that makes sense. So yeah, this one is pretty good. It is sort of similar to the Revlon one in that it does go a little bit darker once it has been applied, and yeah, it does kind of settle into the fine lines a little bit because it is so glossy. And yeah, but it doesn't have like a distinct smell or taste. It's pleasant, it's not anything to complain about. So yeah, I've worn this quite a few times and my friend really likes it as well, so yeah. So if you enjoyed this video and you would like to see a video on pink lipsticks, then feel free to leave a comment down below. Also, I could do one on red lipsticks, but I don't really have any other colours besides two coral lipsticks, but that's not really enough to make a video. You can also request a video on pink lip glosses and nude lip glosses if you are after those, because this one just covered lipsticks because I didn't want the video to be too long. Also, I just recorded a tutorial on this eyeshadow look using my Naked palette that I just received. Yay! A little bit behind the times, but better late than never. Alright, so I will see you guys in my next video. Don't forget to like and comment and subscribe and all that good stuff. Because you're the best. Alright, bye guys.